Hi, I'm Miriam van den Noo and I am the chair of the board of FMN Young. And today we are here in beautiful Antwerp at the Royal Museum of Fine Arts. In this facility tour of World Workplace Europe 2021, we will get an insight into the renovation process of the last 10 years.
I'm Walter Hogerwerf from Kahn Architecten. I'm working on this magnificent project since 2009 as a project leader for the architect's office.
Hi, I'm Wouter Kovins, operational manager of the museum. Started working here 1 year ago. I'm responsible for the facility and the security of the building.
So, Walter, where are we right now and how are you involved in this project? Yeah.
Right now we're in the new entrance hall. The previous words were spoken in the old entrance hall. And now we're in the new entrance halls where there's more ticketing and more information. We were involved in this project in 2003, where we won a competition and with the idea to make the museum bigger from internal and to preserve and make better the monument. If I think about the two biggest challenges we had in this project was that we knew that this museum has this magnificent collection, and that's it's a world-class collection. And our ambition was that the monument and the new museum would be on the same level as this magnificent collection. So that meant the big ambition in design and maintenance of the museum and restoring it, but also to get the routing and the climate, everything on the same high level as the collection itself. Second challenge is, no surprise, budget. We have quite a modest budget if we compare it to museums that were on the same level as this museum. I think about the Rijksmuseum in Amsterdam or the Noyes Museum in Berlin, where their budget was triple the budget for this total project. Nevertheless, we kept the ambition, but compared to that, this budget was not available at the start, how you would dream it would be, but it was available over the years. So getting these finances available over the years also meant getting designs started over the years. And that made it a real big challenge to get it still coherent, fitting in the original master plan we made before all the phases were made.
Okay, so did the plans change a lot during the process?
Yeah, it did. But the advantage of that was that, if I look in hindsight, the good thing was that there was, for instance, for this area, the public's area, the budget to get it really nice was done quite recently. But that also made it possible that we could really fit it to the latest requirements necessary. And the same counts for security. That was also started quite late, and it was really difficult to implement, but that meant that it was really on the latest high standards possible. So those are the advantages, but that's in hindsight. If you're in it, you think, wow, this is really complex to get it done. But in hindsight, it was remarkable.
So, Wouter, how did you get involved in this amazing project?
About a year ago, I solicited on a function for operational manager. It was very interesting to me at the time. I was looking for an opportunity with a lot of variation. And I can say there is a lot of variation in this function. Formerly, I've been responsible for infrastructural management at the University of Antwerp. So I was selected on my experience in facility management and maintenance of large buildings.
And what are the challenges you faced here in the last year?
It's very challenging in the first part to get to know the project and the building. It's very complex. There's a lot of technique in it also. It's a very state-of-the-art museum. Also the challenges towards cleaning even. It's big, it's special, it has to be the most beautiful in the world. So we are looking into that now. And also, of course, security, which is actually new to me. I had to learn it, I'm still learning it, but it's very challenging and it's very interesting also. The total floor space of the museum is 31,000 square meters, of which 19,000 square meters is exposition room. We will expose about 650 works of art in the exposition rooms. We aim for about 300,000 visitors a year, and we have a large depot with about 2,000 artworks stored. In the museum we have a shop and a restaurant. We will work together with external partners for the management of those. For instance, in the shop the visitors will be able to buy art-related souvenirs, and also in the cafeteria and restaurant they will be able to eat and drink to make their visit more pleasant.
So this project started in 2009, we're now in 2021. What happened here? Can you tell us a bit more about whole process?
Yeah. The first phase started in 2009. Before that, so between 2003 and 2009, we made a master plan, and which was coordinated with the KNSK, but also the Flemish government, after which the finances and the building phases were decided. Once that was settled, we could start with the first phase, with the design of the first phase in 2009, and that was the approach for demolition, asbestos removal, and to build a new depot in the center of the museum. When the building phase started, the phase one, we started designing phase two, and that was the renovation of the monument and the design of the new museum. That was the phase two. The phase two design started in 2012, and the building phase of the phase two started when the phase one was finished in 2014. So that was a smooth transition to the next phase. And the phase two is the building phase that we just delivered. So right now all the museum spaces are renovated. The new museum is completely built and finished. The public facilities, the shop is designed and built. The cafe and the bars and the restaurant, it's all built. And right now we are in a smooth transition for the next building phase, and that's the phase of the last part of the building, that's the offices. That will start soon, and at the same time there's another phase starting, that's the phase of the gardens, the exposition design, and there's right now extra detailing of the Rubens and Van Dyck zaal. So those are the next phases that still need to be done. And in the meantime, we are tuning the climate system, because to get it perfect as it should be, it should go through all the seasons. We have the winter, the summer. And after 1 year, we have all the seasons, and then the climate should be really settled. This is the central depot of the KMSK, and it's really built in the center of the museum, and also it was part of the raison d'être of the museum, because the previous museum in the 19th century was destroyed by fire. So one of the main requirements of the new museum that was finished in 1890 was to have a museum that would have a safe bunker in its center, a bomvrije kelder. In the 1950s, they even placed a nuclear bomb shelter in this half part of this depot, and that was to safeguard the Rubens paintings in case of a nuclear attack. But that was in a way that was standing in the way to make a depot. So in phase one of the museum, where we started demolishing, we also built this depot, and we had to start with removing the concrete structure with meter thick walls. After that was removed and the depot was ready, we could place the artwork that was standing here above down in this depot. So imagine we were destroying a concrete bunker while the artwork were above this vault. And what you see here, this is the storage of the big Rubens paintings and the other big 17th and 18th century paintings that were too big to move out of the KMSK. Because as you see, this depot is big, but the collection of KMSK is much bigger. They also have an external depot in the Cartoon-Nazi, also used to exchange paintings for traveling expositions. But these ones could not move. And in the original 19th century design, the room above these vaults have slots in the sides, so they could open a valve and lower the paintings in this space in case of an attack or fire. And in fact, we did the same here. When this depot was finished, they could move the paintings down in this space.
3, 2, 1.
Security-wise, this is of course the heart of the museum at this point. In the future, our top works will be on display in the exposition rooms. The depot is of course easier to secure than the public rooms. In this spot, we are in the center of the building, fully contained. We have complete camera coverage and sensors, so it's actually the easiest part of the building to secure.
Well, we're in a beautiful, white, spacious room. Can you tell us something about the cleaning here, for example?
Yeah, the brilliant white floor. It's the floor itself cleans quite easily. It's only important to have a high frequency of cleaning. So all the dirt is visible on the floor, but you can take it off quite easy.
Can you tell us a bit more about the challenges you faced design-wise and the facilities?
Yeah. During the project phase, it was important. Actually, one of the main drivers of the project was to create more exposition room and also to have a perfect climate for the artworks. So one of the big challenges was to integrate the climate installation in the building without impacting it visually too much. So it's a historic building, you don't want all the techniques visible.
Can you tell us a bit more how the climate installation works, how it's designed?
Yeah, it was designed with a note that it really tries to create an object climate and not so much the whole room. So what we actually do is we let air enter the room parallel to the walls. It falls down actually a bit comparable to a blanket, and then it climatizes a region about 0.5 meter from the wall in the perfect climate for our artworks. This means we don't have to climatize the whole room. And this saves on energy costs, lower air volume, so also lower maintenance costs.
So, of course, a lot has changed in the last year because of COVID-19. Did you make any changes in the whole concept of routing exits and the way in?
Well, it creates challenges. Of course, we have the we are lucky to have a big building like this, so there is a lot of opportunity to keep distance. We have detailed plans ready. The most challenging part in those is, of course, the entrance and exit zone, where two flows of people will cross. But at this point, we are not effectively integrating changes on those. Towards ticketing and time schedules of ticketing, we will anyhow, even without COVID, integrate this in our ticketing strategy. So.
This new museum, the 21st century part, is it's also a lot about routing, but more in verticality. So we have a big elevator as part of the museum route, going all the way up to the top floor. But there's also a shortcut with this long diagonal staircase that goes up to the top floor.
So you told us you are responsible for the safety and security as well. I can imagine that is quite important in a museum. Can you tell us a bit more how you manage that?
Yeah, we have a fully integrated building management system with, for instance, 100% camera coverage. We have artwork tags, we have approaching sensors that give alarm when people would approach a work. We have all kinds of magnetic sensors on doors, on entrances. So we are actually state-of-the-art in security management at this point.
So what happens when someone tries to touch something? What?
They will be killed.
Here we are in the top floor, and this museum floor is dedicated to daylight. And the 19th century museum has their own historic way of providing daylight to the paintings. In this room we took another approach. We made skylights completely directing to get northern light. And we shaped the ceiling in such a way that daylight is spread evenly about in the room, on the wall, but also with enough daylight, but also not too much daylight. Because artwork is very fragile for daylight.
So in this whole project, how's the collaboration between the operational functions and the architect?
Yes, that's a good point. It's been a long process. I've been on it since 2009, so that meant that I've met several predecessors of Wouter, and in the previous phases we had design made, discussed with the user and his predecessor how it will function, how it fits. But they were also involved of all the particularities of the process that we've been in. And I remember when we first met, you came in and then you saw what was made with all these particularities in the design, also concerning ways to get to specific installation components. If you're new in it, you would think, who would invent this like this? But it took some time to get also Wouter more involved in the history of the process, and also in why things are the way that they are. Explained, we have this ambition of the building with the ambition of the architecture, but also with the ambition of the climate and the ambition of the monument, and that all has to fit together. So that meant that some elements require more attention than you would normally expect from a building, since it's not a completely new building, and we were fitting everything in the best possible way.
Yeah. For me, it was challenging to come here 1 year ago. Now it was challenging because you see things in the building, design choices that were made that you don't immediately understand. And then you go to talk to the architect and the design team, and then you start gradually understanding all these things. You get to know the installation, you get to know all the aspects that lead towards the choices that were made. And in the end, you see that this design and this installation is actually integrated in a way that is special in the building, and that is state of the art. We will make this building work. Now we are in the what we call the black box. It's actually a kind of a subfloor where we will present the most precious works. Therefore, it's also a dark space because they are very, very sensitive to light. We are happy to have a test public, which we call the Most Beautiful 100. The coming months, they will test the routing in the museum, how everything works. Even evacuation training we will do with the 100. But also how mock-ups of rooms, how this works for them, how we can improve it. In this way, during this 1 year period, we have the chance to really improve the visitor experience and to become really the most beautiful museum.
This 21st century museum has several routing possibilities where we can connect the different spaces of this new part without getting noticed in the 19th century monument. And we did this, we were to create passages through the 19th century monument. And what we did is we doubled the monumental wall so we could create secret passages to make these several routings possible. In fact, here, around the corner, next to the wall, is a 19th century monumental space. And you don't notice it because you're in this part of the museum.
When are you satisfied in this project? When is it a real success for you?
Personally, I think I would be really fulfilled if in the end the visitors will experience the artwork and the building at the same level, which was our ambition at the start. It's a total experience and enrichment.
I personally will be happy when all the visitors have a fantastic experience in the museum. If the routings are top, if everything works according to the standards that we have set. And I hope to welcome you all in the museum in the coming years. We will publicly expose the opening date 1 year on beforehand with the countdown campaign. But in the next few months we still have a lot of projects to attend, and you are welcome to visit us in the near future.
Thank you so much for joining us, and we hope you have a great time at the rest of World Workplace Europe 2021.